Hello friends, in today's chemistry final punch KCET 2020 I am going to discuss about S block elements. Although very less number of questions they have asked from this chapter, but for NEET exam also or JE exam also it is very, very helpful synopsis. In detail I have explained, definitely if you refer this it will help you. Yes, fine. We know that group 1 and group 2, group 1 elements are also called as alkali metals. In further I will refer it as AM. Group 2 is known as alkaline earth metals, further I will refer it as AEM. So lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. Francium and radium are radioactive elements, remember that. Configuration NS1 and NS2, we know that. Atomic size, so down the group increases. In that case, remember, alkali metals are having more atomic radius than the alkaline earth metals. Ionization energy, here two points are important. First, ionization energy if you consider. So configuration completely filled is this one. Hence, remember, IE1 of AEM is more. Andre, alkaline earth metal is more. IE1 of alkaline earth metals is more. So if you consider here, IE2 means what happens? Already if you have removed one electron from here and one electron from here, this will attain stable noble gas configuration. Hence, very difficult to remove the electron. Because of that reason, IE2 of alkali metals are more than the IE2 of alkaline earth metals. Remember this point. Then metallic nature. Metallic nature alkaline metals is more than the alkaline earth metals. Remember that metallic nature, the inversely proportional to ionization energy. So ionization energy of the alkali metals is less, hence it is molecular, the metallic nature is more. Then important, alkali metals show more efficient close packing. So remember, close packing of the alkaline earth metals is more. Because of that reason, alkaline earth metals are hard, these are soft, these are brittle, these are ductile. Alkaline earth metals are having high melting and boiling point, alkali metals are having low melting and boiling point. Low means compared to alkaline earth metals I am talking about. So alkali metals are having less density, alkaline earth metals are having more density. Remember this point. Then if you consider melting and boiling point, decreases down the group. The reason for that is, remember, so first element, lithium and beryllium are showing more close packing. So metallic bond strength is very, very high. Because of that reason, elements are very closely packed. Hence, so melting and boiling point decreases down the group. These are having more. Then density, exceptional one. So you have to remember, once it was asked, remember in CET, density is exceptional. Exceptional means lithium less than potassium. We expect sodium here. So, but sodium is more than potassium. This is the exception and there is no particular reason for that. So, this is an experimentally determined concept. So, Li less than potassium, less than sodium, less than rubidium, less than cesium. So we expect Li less than sodium, then potassium, but Li less than potassium is the answer. So potassium less than sodium, this is the point you have to remember. And then flame color. So very simple, what we have seen this experimentally also in your labs. So due to high ionization energy and alkaline earth metals, ionization energy is high, beryllium and magnesium does not give any color. These two will element, so they will never show any color to the flame because of the high ionization energy. But remaining, you remember, lithium, crimson red, see, sodium golden yellow, potassium violet, lilac also we will call it as, rubidium red violet, cesium blue, calcium brick red, strontium crimson red, barium apple green. So two times if you read this, definitely you can tell because it is experimentally seen by you, right? So then hydration energy, very, very important concept in S block element. So hydration energy means, remember, the energy released when these ions are dissolved in water, these compounds of this alkali metal or alkaline earth metals are dissolved in water. So this hydration depending on the size, so inversely proportional to size. Remember, hydration energy inversely proportional to size. So if size is less, energy released will be more. So in that case, alkali metals, you can see, so lithium plus is more because size is less, cesium plus is less, that is size is more. Like that, beryllium 2 plus is more than Ba2+. See, this hydration energy will affect mobility and conductivity. Mobility and conductivity. See, atomic size, if I consider, cesium is more than the lithium, correct? Because atomic size down the group, what happens? Increases. But hydrated ion size, lithium plus is more. Hydrated ion size I am talking about, just imagine, hydrated ion size means when lithium plus and Cs plus dissolve in water, because of the small size of the lithium, hydration energy is very, very high, which means size of the lithium increases. we are not talking about individual atom or the ion. So hydrated ion size increases, hence mobility in the solution. Remember, mobility means movement. Then the movement is depending on the size, we know that. So if the size is more, movement will be less. If the size is more, movement will be less. Hence, remember, lithium plus hydrated ion size. So lithium plus is very, very less movement in the solution than cesium plus. Cesium plus is having more movement in the solution. That movement decides conductivity, because conductivity, that is current carrying capacity in the solution, depending on the movement of the ions. So movement of the ions is more for cesium, hence conductivity is also more for cesium. Remember that point. Then this relationship, you remember, it will help you. Solubility inversely directly proportional to hydration energy, inversely proportional to lattice energy. So remember this point. So hydration energy, lattice energy will decide the solubility. But which factor predominates over which factor, depending on that particular molecule. So this is the solubility dependent. So reducing nature, important. Remember, reducing nature generally inversely proportional to ionization energy. Reducing nature means what? The element which can readily give electrons. So alkaline earth metals can give readily electrons, we know that. So ionization energy is less for them. So ionization energy less, hydration and this reducing energy will be more, reducing nature will be more, fine. So if you see this alkali metal, cesium more than rubidium more than potassium more than sodium, no doubt this is the order we expect. And remember, lithium we expected here, but experimentally lithium is more than the cesium. For that, ionization energy is not the reason. Another reason is there. That is high hydration energy. It is also experimental determined. If you see the electrochemical series, you can see lithium at the top having more negative reduction potential, which means very good reducing agent. The reason for that is more hydration energy. Remember, we expect this. This is the one where here lithium we expect, but lithium is here. Then, don't expect beryllium here now, because lithium is here, hence beryllium also we expect here, wrong. So here there is no exception, barium more than strontium more than calcium more than magnesium more than beryllium. Alkaline earth metal, no exception, but remember this. Then metallic bond strength, as I told, metallic bond strength for the lithium is highest, so decreases down the group. Beryllium is more, decreases down the group. Hence boiling and melting point also decreases down the group. Photoelectric effect. So photoelectric effect increases down the group. Remember that. So photoelectric effect. So it is depending on the ionization energy. Ionization energy decreases, so photoelectric effect increases. Chemical properties, very important point with air. So clearly I have explained, see that. So what happens? First, metal when it reacts with oxygen to form oxides. Right? So that oxide, if it reacts with the moisture to form hydroxide. This hydroxide when it reacts with the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere to form carbonate. So this is a continuous reaction which can take place. So some passage type of question, it is necessary. So remember that. So not only for CET, NEET and JEE also, it is very, very important. Fine. So always remember, in this particular case, so here, highly reactive and stored in the kerosene. Remember, with air, all these elements are, that is AM anta baridini. So AM, that is alkaline earth metals, are highly reactive with the oxygen. Hence, remember, it is present in the kerosene oil. Only lithium, which is present in the wax. Remember that. Then, so remember here, only oxides are not going to form. Lithium forms only oxide. That is lithium oxide, Li2O. But sodium forms sodium peroxide. Excess of air I am talking about. Oxide is formed by all the elements. But lithium forms only monoxide. Potassium, sodium forms sodium peroxide. So oxide also possible, but peroxide is possible, but lithium peroxide not possible. And potassium, rubidium, cesium forms, remember, superoxides. Formula KO2, RbO2, CSO2. So superoxides, formula KO2, RbO2, CSO2. And one thing you remember, superoxide formula, superoxide possible from only the elements present in alkali metal. Nowhere you will see the superoxide concept. Nowhere we will see. So very, very important, because of the larger size of the potassium, rubidium, cesium, so you can expect superoxide formation in this case. Very, very, very important point. So remember that. Now, reactivity of the oxygen increases down the group. So remember, reactivity goes on, increases down the group. First of all, one thing you remember here, first two elements, first means in this lithium, in this beryllium, they are very less reactive. very less react. This is general point. Remember, the question may be asked on anything. So very less reactive, beryllium and lithium. Then remember, as the size of this atoms, K, potassium, rubidium, cesium increases, stability of peroxides and superoxides also increases. Which means, down the group, peroxide formation, superoxide formation increases. Why? What is the reason? Because size increases, stability of the peroxide and superoxide increases. That is due to stabilization of large cation with large anion. One hint I will tell you, my dear students. Remember this point for longer days. So, larger the cation, larger the anion, stability will be more. Smaller the cation, smaller the anion, stability will be more. When larger and smaller they will mix, stability will be less. Very simple. Larger, larger, smaller, smaller, stability will be more. And smaller, larger, stability will be less. So remember that point. Fix that in your mind. So superoxide or peroxide ion size is larger. Hence, down the group, the stability increases because large cations stabilized by large anions. Because in such case, remember, lattice energy will be more. Lattice energy will be more. So remember that point. Then oxides. Some important points about oxides. We know that oxides are O2 minus charge, diamagnetic in nature. So one thing you remember, oxides, when they dissolve in water, it is going to form hydroxide. Fix this in the point. So only hydroxide is going to form. Peroxides, O minus 1, diamagnetic. So with water, it will form hydroxide. But along with that, hydrogen peroxide is extra here. Remember this point. Superoxide, O to the power minus half, paramagnetic. With water, hydroxide is formed, hydrogen peroxide. Oxygen is extra. See, down the ground, down under oxide to peroxide to superoxide, one product is going to increase. Hydroxide plus peroxide plus oxygen gas. This was asked once in the CET exam. Remember this. Yes, with water. With water, remember, hydroxides are going to form and hydrogen gas is released. And we know that once again, reactivity increases down the group. So, stability of the alkali metal hydroxides, remember, solubility and stability both are increases. Solubility and stability, thermal stability we call it as. So, solubility, stability, basic nature of hydroxide. All the three easy to remember increases down the group. So, cesium hydroxide is more basic than the sodium hydroxide, like that. Solubility, stability, basic nature increases down the group. All are thermally stable. Remember, all these are thermally stable. In that thermal stability, down the group increases. Except lithium hydroxide. Lithium hydroxide is very less stable. The reason for that is, remember, lithium hydroxide. Hydroxide is larger ion. Lithium is smaller ion. So, small and large, it will not form a stable bond. Hence, remember, so down the group stability increases. This will have least stability. When it is heated, remember, thermally, when directly give rise to Li2 and H2O very easily. But sodium hydroxide will not form like this. Remember that. Only lithium hydroxide will form like this. Then with hydrogen. With hydrogen, remember, hydrides are formed. Hydrides are formed, remember. Ionic hydrides. All these are ionic nature. So, ionic nature increases down the group because electronegative difference increases. See, CS hydrogen, electronic difference is very, very high. Ionic nature is more. Here, less. Ionic nature is less. Remember that. See, stability of the hydrides decreases down the group. See, here stability increases, we told. Here stability decreases, we told. See, I told that. I told already, right? So, larger plus larger, stability will be, stability is more. Remember this point. Either smaller plus smaller, stability will be more. But if it is smaller plus larger or vice versa, so stability will be less, decreases. Here smaller, larger of cation and anion I am talking about. Here you can see, hydroxide is larger ion, definitely OH minus. And metal size increases down the group, stability increases. But here, hydrogen size is very, very, very small. Because of that reason, down the group, stability decreases. Remember this point. So, not only for this, most of the compounds, you can apply this particular concept in S block elements. So, hence, lithium hydride is more stable than cesium hydride. Fine. With halogen, With halogen, remember, halides are formed, MX type of halides. Reactivity of the metals of the same halogen increases down the group. See, this I have told in all the cases. Here also increases everywhere. Reactivity of the halogen with same metal decreases. See, reactivity of the halogen with the same metal decreases. Right? So, reactivity of the metal with the same halogen increases. Remember that point. For same alkali metal, the melting point decreases in the order. For same alkali metals, so for example, I have given NaF, NaCl, NaBr, NaI. So melting point order, how it is? Fluorides more than chlorides, more than bromides, more than iodides. What is the reason? See, ionic nature is more. Ionic nature is more because of this, the electronegativity difference. Because of that reason, ionic nature will be more. So now, because of the ionic nature, decrease in the lattice energy. And then down the group, ionic nature decreases, lattice energy decreases. For this, lattice energy is more because ionic nature is more because of the difference in the electronegativity. For this, generally you remember this point. So down the group, fluoride to chloride to bromide to iodides, so melting point decreases. See, for same halide ion and different metals. Melting point of the lithium halide is less than sodium halide. Then after it decreases. See, one example I have given. LiCl, NaCl, KCl. LiCl is less than NaCl. Then NaCl to KCl decreases, no doubt. So LiCl is less than NaCl. The reason for that is covalent nature. Very, very important. Covalent nature. See, lithium is always forming covalent bonds easily. That is because of the reason is smaller size and higher polarizing power, we call it as. Right? So remember that. Then with liquid ammonia, very important concept. Similarly, alkaline earth metals also there. There I have not discussed this point. Fine. Liquid ammonia, what happens is, what to remember? When metals are dissolved in ammonia, you are going to get metal ammonia complex and electron ammonia complex. This we call it as solvated electron. So then metal ammonia solutions are colored in nature, give reason anta kelthare. So give reason means it is because of the solvating electron, deep blue color is obtained. Solvated electron, or you can also call it as ammoniated electron. These are all blue colored solution. Remember, color is because of ammoniated electron or solvated electron and highly conducting in nature. Because of the electrons, remember, so conductivity is very, very high and strong reducing in nature. Because of this reason, this is used as a Birch reduction. If you remember, alkynes converted into the trans alkenes, we have used this Birch reduction. Lithium in liquid ammonia or sodium in liquid ammonia, right? Less than 3 molar concentration. Remember, 3 molarity, 3M concentration of this solution. Solution is blue and paramagnetic. It's important for only neat, blue and paramagnetic. But color changes to bronze when 3M solution become more than 3M solution. So become diamagnetic in nature. Remember, color changes to bronze color above 3 molar solution. Below 3 molar or less than 3 molar, so blue and paramagnetic. Above 3 molar, so it become diamagnetic. Remember that point. So very important point. Some exceptional behavior we will see. Only lithium react with nitrogen to form lithium nitride. Important. Note on this point. Only lithium react with nitrogen to form lithium nitride. Other element does not react. So lithium nitride dissolve in water, liberating ammonia gas. Anyway, any nitrides dissolving water, you are going to get ammonia gas. No doubt. See, important. Only lithium forms carbide. Other element does not form. Remember that point. Remember, already we have seen some more points. Only lithium forms the oxide. It will not form peroxide, superoxide. Only lithium forms lithium nitride. Only lithium forms lithium carbide. Remember that point. Addition to that, you can see lithium carbonate and lithium bicarbonate exist only in the solution. It will never exist in the solid state. Lithium carbonate and lithium bicarbonate only exist in the solution. Then stability and solubility. This order is very important and very easy to remember, you can see. So stability and solubility of any compound, they can ask. Carbonate, bicarbonate, nitrate, sulfate. See, carbonate, bicarbonate, nitrate, sulfate increases down the group from lithium to cesium. See, addition to that, hydroxide also, solubility and stability increases down the group. So, right? So, one thing is very simple. In alkali metal, any compounds, if I take solubility and stability, both increases down the group. Only hydride stability, so decreases down the group because it is a smaller anion, leave it. But remaining all are remember increases down the group, right? So solubility depends on hydration energy, or you can say solubility depends on lesser the lattice energy, solubility will be more, right? But stability, how to calculate? I told, see, metals, carbonates are larger in ion, CO3, HCO3, NO3, SO4, OH, all these are larger cation stabilized by larger anions. These are stabilized by larger cations. Larger cations are nothing but, remember, that is down the group, larger cation size increases, because of that reason stability increases. See, only lithium nitrate on heating forms nitrogen dioxide gas. Very important point, exception. Only lithium, it's also asked in KCET, remember that. So only lithium nitrate give rise to NO2, but other nitrates give rise to MnO3, give rise to MnO2 plus O2. MnO2 means nitrates. For example, see, if I consider NaNO3, LiNO3 forming Li2NO2O2, but NaNO3 is forming NaNO2 plus O2, remember. NaNO2 plus O2, very important difference you have to remember. Then sodium hydroxide. So quickly we'll see, sodium hydroxide is also called as caustic soda. So first preparation, remember, sodium chloride solution, that is brine solution, when it undergo electrolysis, we are going to get sodium hydroxide, hydrogen gas at like cathode, and Cl2 gas at anode, it released. Then Kastner-Kellner cell, important, which is cathode, which is anode, like that, remember. So NaCl solution is electrolyzed. Once again, brine solution is electrolyzed. Cathode is mercury, and anode is carbon. Graphite, remember that. Right? So a mercury cathode, what happens is, so it will form sodium amalgam, which is dissolved in water, forming sodium hydroxide. Very important. So at anode, Cl2 gas is released. So sodium amalgam gives rise to sodium hydroxide, and which gas is released on the calendar? Hydrogen gas in this Kastner-Kellner cell. Sodium carbonate solvase process, very simple. Ammonia, water, and carbon dioxide, you have to mix. It is forming ammonium carbonate. Ammonium carbonate with NaCl forming NaHCO3. That NaHCO3 dissolve in the NaHCO3 is heated, you are going to get Na2CO3. Very simple solvays process. Ammonia, water, carbon dioxide, ammonium carbonate, then NaCl, NaHCO3, then Na2CO3. Now, important point is, along with this, another byproduct is formed, ammonium chloride, NH4Cl. This NH4Cl, from which ammonia gas is recovered, recovery of the ammonia, how? Calcium hydroxide, slaked lime, you have to introduce. Once it was asked in NEET, remember. So ammonium chloride react with calcium hydroxide, slaked lime, forming ammonia gas, CaCl2 and water. Very important. This overall, remember, if you see what all the raw material required for the solvays process, ammonia, calcium carbonate, NaCl. From where this calcium carbonate came? See, here carbon dioxide is required. From where you will get calcium carbonate? Carbon dioxide, calcium carbonate, when it is heated, you are going to get calcium carbon. CO2. So hence, remember, CaCO3 is a raw material, NH3 is raw material, NaCl is raw material. If you have these three along with water, you are going to get sodium carbonate. Then potassium carbonate cannot be prepared from this method. Very important, another important statement. Reason is KHCO3 more soluble in the water than NaHCO3. See, here NaHCO3 is found, correct? See, this NaHCO3 is very less soluble in the water. Because of that reason, it is stable. But KHCO3 is more soluble in the water. Hence, you cannot prepare NaK2CO3 from using this method. Finally, baking soda, very simple. It is also called as washing soda, remember. Na2CO3 is known as soda ash. Remember this. It is not washing soda. Na2CO3 is known as soda ash. Na2CO3-10S2 is known as washing soda. 10S2 hydrated salt is known as washing soda. NaHCO3, baking soda, Na2CO3 plus water plus CO2, NaHCO3 is going to form. So this reaction, reversible reaction, it is actually a reversible reaction. This is forming sodium bicarbonate. Then with water, chemical properties of alkaline earth metal we will discuss. This is about alkali metals. So once again, go through the video, very simple, very nicely explained. This material also I will send you in the WhatsApp. Only thing what you have to do is you have to subscribe to my channel. Then below that I have given the WhatsApp link or the Instagram link, the Telegram link. So Telegram link also you can use if you have Telegram. WhatsApp alle barbeku ante enilla. In Telegram also I have made the group. So there you will get all these nice colorful notes, my handwritten notes for you. Remember that. So with water, form hydroxide, we know that right? Reactivity increases down the group. Already we have seen beryllium does not react with water. Definitely reactivity increases down the group means beryllium is very least reactive. Magnesium, remember, with cold water no reaction, with hot water it react. Cold water does not react, hot water it react. Then calcium, strontium, barium, with both it will react because they are more reactive in nature, water. Then with air, very simple. With air, remember, in this particular case, with air, both oxides and nitrides are formed. But in case of the alkali metals, if you remember, only lithium forms nitride. But here both can form nitride. That is, oxide and nitrides are found by all the elements. There is no exception. Reactivity increases down the group, remember. Beryllium and magnesium forms protective layer. Generally, beryllium and magnesium does not react with oxygen very readily. Reason is, this will form a protective layer around the that particular surface. Large cation stabilizes the anions. Peroxides are also formed. Remember, superoxide does not form, but peroxides are going to form. BaO2, SrO2 is the formula. Peroxides are going to form. See, very important this order. Basic nature of the oxide and hydroxide increases, no doubt. Alkali metals also, we have seen the same. Solubility, stability of hydroxide increases, no doubt. Alkali metals also, we have seen the same. Andre, hydroxides and oxides, remember this point. Hydroxides and oxide, both alkali and alkaline metals, increases down the group. Then, beryllium, note, very note, important note is that beryllium is amphoteric in nature, which reacts with both acid as well as base, hence it is amphoteric. Not only beryllium, beryllium oxide and hydroxide is also amphoteric. Very, very, very important point. Beryllium, hydroxide and oxide, both are amphoteric and the element also amphoteric. So beryllium reacts with both acid as well as base. Remember this point. With halogen. With halogen, halides are going to form. Directly halides are going to form. Very important, beryllium halide. The beryllium does not react directly. See, this beryllium part, here also least reactive, here also less reactive. See, here also with hydrogen, form hydride directly with hydrogen, but except beryllium once again. So with carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, it will not react directly because least reactive, that is beryllium. Fine. How you can prepare then? BeO react with C plus Cl2, you are going to get CO plus BeCl2. Or another method, this carbon tetrachloride with BeO also, you are going to get BeCl2. Fine. Important this point. Remember, important this point. Beryllium halides are covalent and remaining are ionic. Because of that covalent nature, it can exhibit dimer state in the vapor phase, dimer state in the vapor phase, polymer in the solid state, remember, polymer in the solid state, monomer in the more than 1200 Kelvin. Monomer 1200 Kelvin, more than that, you will get monomer. How the structure will be there? Dimer. Because of this reason, you can say beryllium and aluminium is diagonally related. Because aluminium chloride is also dimer, remember, aluminium chloride is also dimer. So, dimer, aluminium, beryllium chloride, polymer, polymer it is, and monomer, BeCl2, 180 degree sp hybridization for beryllium. With hydrogen form hydrides, directly react with hydrogen, so except beryllium. Beryllium form, beryllium hydride, how it is formed? BeCl2 react with lithium aluminum hydroxide, so beryllium hydride is formed. But remaining element directly react with hydrogen gas to form hydrides. Then remember, stability of hydrides decreases down the group. Once again, we have explained the same. So hydrides, the hydrogen, the anion is very small, hence stability decreases down the group. With carbon, remember, carbides are going to form. With carbides, remember, beryllium react with carbon to form Be2C. Be2C and Be2C in water forming CH4BeOH twice. Exceptional behavior of beryllium, remember that. But remaining can form MC2 type. Remaining can form MC2 type. Very, very important. Only beryllium form Be2C. Be2C. In water forming CH4. But remaining form MC2. MC2 is again in water. MOH twice plus CH triple bond CH. Ethyne or acetylene is going to form. Methane, acetylene. But in that, once again, magnesium is exception. Very important for only neat. Only neat. Only neat. I will tell you. With exception for Mg. So Mg, what happens is, MgC2 will form, no doubt. But react with some more amount of carbon immediately from Mg2C3. Mg2C3 is going to form propyne. Very easy to see. 1 carbon methane, 2 carbon ethyne, 3 carbon propyne. So propyne gas is going to form with Mg. Very, very important point, remember. Then stability and solubility, both here different. See, stability of carbonate, bicarbonate, sulfate, nitrate, all the 4 increases down the group. Here also increases, alkali metals also increases, note down that point. But solubility of all these decreases down the group. Solubility of all this decreases down the group. Remember, only solubility of the hydroxides increases down the group. Remember, very easy, once you close your eyes and revise the things. Alkali metals, all the compounds, hydroxides, carbonate, bicarbonate, nitrate, sulfate, everything, it is going to increase us down the group, solubility or stability. But here, only hydroxide both increases down the group. But remaining stability increases, but solubility decreases down the group. Very important, solubility decreases down the group. Note down this point. Fine. Compounds of calcium, we are going to discuss in the next whole, the flow chart. CaO, CaCO3, CaOH2, CaSO4, 2H2, CaSO4, half H2O. Remember, the formula once it was asked, gypsum, 2H2O, plastopheris, half H2O, slaked lime it is, limestone, quick lime. See, this is a very beautiful flow chart I have drawn. This much if you remember, so it is enough for any NEET or CET or JE exam, believe me, trust me. So, now, this is the one way. Answer again, I will tell you, Telegram or WhatsApp, this is I am going to share because maximum students should get the use of this. Remember, if you are not subscribed to my channel, subscribe to channel and definitely you will get the use from my channel. Fine. So, in this particular case, I have written 4. CaCO3, CaO, CaSO4, CaOH twice. See how it is. See, first one, CaCO3 when it is heated, you are going to get CaO. Right? Calcium carbonate limestone when it is heated, CaO is going to form. How calcium carbonate is formed? See, sodium carbonate react with calcium chloride forming calcium carbonate. Sodium chloride with sodium carbonate with calcium chloride. This is one preparation. Most of this limestone is available in the nature, that is the naturally occurring. Hence, there is no problem for that. Now, CaCl to Na2CO3 forming Na2CO3. CaCO3. See, CaCl to Na2CO3 forming CaCO3. Arrow mark yav kade ide anta nodi. If the arrow mark is this side, then the product is this one. Remember. Then the reactions you can see. So another method is there. Calcium hydroxide react with CaO2, you are going to get CaCO3. Lime water test we call it as. Remember lime water test for carbonate radical? The same. Now, properties. On heating, CaO. Which react with carbonate? Remember, which react with carbonate? CaHCO3 twice. Which react with carbonate? CaHCO3 twice. So which react with sulfuric acid? CaSO4CO2H2O. Which react with sulfuric acid? CaSO4CO2 and H2O. Fine. Now, CaO. CaO with carbon, calcium carbide. Already we have seen. CaO with carbon, calcium carbide. So remember that. So CaO with SO3 forming CaSO4. Sulfuric trioxide, CaSO4. Sulfur dioxide, CaSO3, sulfite. With SiO2, CaSiO3. CaSO3 where you have seen, which is acting as a slag. And CaO act as a basic flux. In case of the iron extraction, if you remember, SiO2 is an acidic gang. So with HCl forming CaCl2. With HCl forming CaCl2. With one important thing is, so remember, with sodium hydroxide, it's called as soda lime. Soda lime. With sodium hydroxide called as soda lime. So decarboxylating agent. Decarboxylating agent in the organic chemistry we have used. Fine. So CaO react with water forming CaOH twice. Calcium hydroxide, how it is formed? So calcium oxide plus water CaOH twice. Now, CaOH twice. CaOH twice in amorphous form, it's called as slaked lime. So remember the difference I am going to tell. CaOH twice with amorphous form, it is slaked lime. Actually, CaOH twice, whatever you will get, that is slaked lime. So that is, amorphous form will be there. And with water forming saturated white solution. With water when you add, immediately it will form a saturated white solution. That is called as milk of lime. Milk of lime, slaked lime. This is not lime water. Lime water is next one. After dissolving in water, if you filter this, clear solution you are going to get. Clear solution you are going to get. Then this is, remember, lime water. So, CaOH twice in amorphous form, slaked lime. With water, saturated solution, white solution, milk of lime. Filter, lime water. Lime water means filtered clear solution. Remember that part. Then, CaOH twice is used in, remember, softening of hard water. Softening of hard water. Remember that point also. Softening of hard water. And also CaOH twice when it reacts with Cl2 forming bleaching powder. Bleaching powder. So, composition of bleaching powder, everything in the P block element I have explained. So, you can see that. So, bleaching powder. Then, important CaSO4. CaSO4, remember, in form of 2H2O, it's called as gypsum. Natural occurring, gypsum. When it is dissolved, when it is heated 120 degrees Celsius, water molecule is removed. Minus 1.5 moles of water molecule, once it was asked. So, 1.5 moles of water molecule. So, what is the difference in water molecules between calcium gypsum and gypsum, it is not gypsum, So gypsum and POP, Plaster of Paris, they have asked 1.5 mole or 1.5. Remember, when it is heated at 120 degrees Celsius, calcium hydroxide, calcium sulfate, half H2O, that is POP. It's also written as like this also. 2 calcium sulfate, 1 H2O. 1 calcium sulfate, half H2O, nothing but 2 calcium sulfate, 1 H2O. Remember that, POP. POP, one important point is that up to 140 degree, it is stable. Up to 140. More than 140 degree, it will form CaSO4. CaSO4 is nothing but called as dead burnt plaster. See, when it is heated more than 140 degrees Celsius, completely this half H2 also it is removed. So, it is forming dead burnt plaster. Very, very important. What is the formula of dead burnt plaster? CaSO4. This was also asked once. Remember that. Then cement, finally. Cement, finely powdered mixture of calcium silicate and aluminum silicate is called as cement. Then Portland cement, remember the composition. Once it was asked in NEET exam. Composition, remember. How to remember? Very simple mnemonics I will tell. Lessimis. What is that? Lessimis. Composition of the cement, Portland cement is Lessimis. What is that? Lessimis. Lessimis means what? See, L means lime. So lime is 50 to 60% CaO. S means silica. SiO2 20 to 25%. These two are maximum percentage. So 50 to 60 to 25. Then A means Al2O3. 5 to 10%. M means MgO. 2 to 5%. I means iron oxide. 1 to 2%. S means SO3, 1 to 2%. See. So hence I told very simple, very easy to remember. Lessimis. See. 5 times if you tell, definitely you can remember this thing. Lime, silica, Al2O3, MgO, iron oxide and SO3. What is setting of cement? Setting of cement is nothing but, so exothermic process. So settling of cement. Gypsum increases the setting time. Gypsum, if you don't add, what happens is, cement will undergo setting very easily. So, the rate of setting will be very, very high for cement so that brittleness will be observed. So, hence, remember, gypsum is added which will increase the setting time, decreases the rate of setting. Increase the setting time means decreases the rate of setting. Two important, if you are NEET student, very important biological importance. Sodium and potassium, very simple. In biology also, we will discuss that. Transmission of nerve signals, we know that. Activation of enzymes, flow of water, responsible by this Na and K. Then, sodium plus. See, sodium present in outside the cell in blood plasma. K plus inside the cell. So, sodium outside the cell. Potassium, activate enzymes responsible for oxidation of glucose to ATP. Remember this point. Then calcium and magnesium. Very simple, magnesium catalyzes many enzymes, enzymatic reaction present in chlorophyll. Remember, it is present in chlorophyll. Then calcium, very, very important. 99% body calcium is bones in the teeth. So 99% body calcium present in bones and the teeth. Remember this point. And very important point is this. This point is important. Remember this and this. Calcium 2 plus important in blood clotting. Why it is used? So why it is required? So blood clotting important. It will stop the blood clotting. Contraction of muscles, very, very important. Contraction of muscles and regulates the heartbeat. Heartbeat regulate correct agirbekondre calcium is needed. So calcium important in blood clotting, contraction of muscles and regulates heartbeat. Then calcium in body is maintained by whatever the calcium percentage in our body, which is maintained by two hormones. Remember that calcitosin and parathyroid. What is that? Calcitosin and parathyroid. So this completes, remember. So S block elements. I hope you understood. So if you understood, if you go through this particular video, if you understood, you share to your friends maximum and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like the press the like button, because that is the motivation and energy for me to teach this. Remember, the hard work behind this is very more, because you can see, I will show you my book. See, all this I have written. See this. Complete one book is over. So, I will show you two books. This is one book and this is one book. See, completely this book is also over. And one thing you remember, so for a jokes, take it in light note. So when I was a student, I have not written this much. Remember that. So fine. This is about S block elements. Yes. Now we'll see previous year questions. Now in case of the previous year questions, very simple. 2016 to 2006, 2019, all the questions I have considered here. So very easily you can do it. So among the alkali metals, cesium is the most reactive, because see, in this case, it's incomplete shell is nearer to the nucleus, it has single electron, it is heaviest alkali metal, outermost electron is most loosely bond. Most reactive, because D is the answer. Very simple. When KBr dissolves in water, K plus ions are what? Hydrated. Very simple. Hydration is very important. The characteristic not related to alkali metal, see, their ions are isoelectronic, correct, low melting point. So, low boiling, low electronegativity, high ionization energy, definitely low melting point is also correct. Low electronegativity, high ionization energy is wrong, right? for alkali metals. So alkali metals, which one of the following is trend is incorrect? See, yavadu nodbeku exception yavadu ide, density. Density less than sodium is there. So answer should be the density. Lithium less than sodium is there, but lithium less than potassium should be there. See, in 50 seconds we have finished 4 questions. Adakke helidu, your synopsis should be very clear. For that synopsis, you refer my colorful notes. Definitely it will going to help you. Right. Now, 2012 last question. See, this is 2006, 7, 9, 10. Right? 2012. In some years, they have not asked any questions, remember, because it is very less number of questions it is asked. Total from 2006 to 2019, if you consider around 15 years papers, I will show you only 10 questions out of that. But if for NEET and JEE exam, it is important. See, if it is one question also, it will make a difference of one mark in CET. One mark make a difference of around rankings, remember, 200 to 300 rankings. Hence, very important point. The reaction between sodium and water can be made less vigorous by. See, less vigorous. Sodium and water reaction is very, very fast, remember. So, lowering temperature, there is no way, because sodium react with cold water also and hot water also. Adding little alcohol. See, little alcohol react with sodium very easily to form sodium alkoxide. Hence, you cannot add. Adding little acetic acid. Remember, acetic acid and sodium, but acetic acid dissolve in water very easily. It will not decrease the reactivity. Further, it will increase the reactivity. Hence, amalgamating sodium is the best option. Because when sodium react with mercury to form amalgam, so that amalgam sodium will not react further. Hence, the answer is C. Alkali metals have negative reduction potential, hence they behave as. Remember in the electrochemical series, negative reduction potential means they are good reducing agents, very important. Then, metallic oxide, I told you, metallic oxide react with water to form its the hydroxide, hydrogen peroxide and also liberates oxygen. The metallic oxide could be. See, which is the metallic oxide? See, oxide under it is not only the only oxide, remember. It may be peroxide, superoxide, they are talking in terms of. So, which reacts with the water to form three compounds? Three compounds superoxide, two compound per hydrogen peroxide and this hydroxide, two compound peroxide, one compound oxide. Remember that point. So, KO2 is the answer in this case. KO2 is the answer. Plaster of Paris is represented by very simple formula. Plaster of Paris, CaSO4. 2S, this half H2O, remember, POP, Plaster of Paris, CaSO4, half H2O. Dead burn plaster, 2018, dead burn plaster, very simple, CaSO4, very simple. Correct? So, metal nitrate that liberate NO2 on heating, only LiNO3. This is the exception for lithium. So, only LiNO3 is forming Li2O plus NO2 plus O2. NO2 on heating, only this. Remaining, it will form only MNO3. Give rise to MnO2 plus O2. There is no nitrogen dioxide release. MnO2 is formed, remember. So, this is about S block elements. So, previous year questions along with the super synopsis. So, if you have visited my channel for the first time, I am requesting you to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Like this, remember, you can expect very good content from my channel. So, thank you. Have a nice day.